Hi, I'm Severi from Hornet Plugins. We are here for a new tutorial on our AutoGain Pro. This time we're gonna show you how to use one of our best sellers with Pro Tools, the de facto standard in professional audio production. We recently released the AAX version for Pro Tools 11 and 12, and we are very excited about it because we can now enter the professional recording studios. I think this utility will be very helpful even to professionals. It's already loved by many amateurs and project studios, and it's a perfect tool for saving time for vocal automation and other automation in general. I've prepared an example session here with a track containing the music of a song that I recorded and produced, and the other one containing the vocals. We are going to use AutoGain Pro to balance the vocals on the music automatically. Then we record the automation and eventually we can edit at a later time. So the first thing we are gonna do is to take our AutoGain Pro and insert it in the vocal channel. Here it is. The plugin is pretty easy, even if there are quite a lot of controls, but they are self-explanatory and we won't adjust them now. We just use it as it is, just to show you how it works. We can use it internally with an internal reference that is set using the gain level knob, but for this example we are going to use the external routing. So we'll use the music, the track with the music, as an external key to the processor, so that the vocals will always be at the level of the music every time. To do this, we'll first use a send on our music track and send it to our stereo bus 1 and 2. Then, on the key input of the AutoGain Pro, we will use bus number 1. The key input in Pro Tools is always a mono bus, so if you choose left or right, it's the same. And we will for start set it at 0 for our send. And playing the track now will let you see that this line, the yellow one, is the gain is the gain line, will be adjusted in real time when the reference here, the white line, changes. So let's press play. Now we stop hiding. See that it's recording, it's processing the audio. Okay. Now I'm gonna put my headphones on so I can have a better listen and mix the tracks. As you can listen, the vocal track is a little bit low in volume regards to the music, but it's moving together with the music, so now I'm gonna adjust it to put it at the same level using the Pro Tools faders. So, the vocals is already sitting pretty well on the music, and now we want to record the automation that the AutoGain Pro is producing, so that we can modify it at a later time. To do this, we'll select the gain parameter from the plugin automation window. We set the track to latch or touch any or write any writing automation writing mode in Pro Tools, then we set AutoGame Pro in write mode, so every change to the game is written to the host, and we press play once again. Okay, if we have a look to the automated parameters here, we see that the automation has been written as it was generated by the plugin. If we wanted to make some changes, some edits, we could just take our drawing tool and change it. But for us, it's perfect as it is generated by the plugin. We can read it back, setting the plugin in read mode and changing from latch to read. So we start here. Okay, as you can see, the automation is read back and applied as it was written the first time. The advantage of this is that you can edit it, and in this mode the plugin uses very few CPUs, so you can have as many instances as you want. Of course, it offers many other features, and like the classic, turning this on make the plugin works at our classic auto gain. You can apply reverse gain, so if it works in reverse. You can work on RMS or peak detection type, internal or external, with a gate that helps you exclude the lower passages, and attack and release time for the detectors. This is very useful because you of course have to adapt attack and release time to the material you are having, or an HPF or LPF filter that help you concentrate on the sound you want. Perhaps you are using it to automate a bass. I will put this down to 20 Hz and then the LPF down to something like 2000 Hz, something like that. With a gain level knob, you can adjust the internal reference or apply some gain offset to the external reference. You have to try it out, and it offers a lot of possibilities. You can do that on www.hornetplugins.com. So go there, download the demo and try it out. Let us know what you think about it. Thank you very much for watching.